returned home. Alan Towers is our reporter.
It was like no other moment in the club's history. The crowds were out on the 15-mile Potteries tour to greet with real delight a side that's won many new friends this season. On Saturday, Vale dominated the first half at Wembley, Paul Kerr giving them an early lead against Stockport, the side they'd knocked out of the promotion playoffs. The team were in great spirits, making sure that everyone along the route got a wave. Vale had done themselves proud at Wembley, as the skipper acknowledged.
We've had a few injuries all through the season, and everybody stuck together. Hopefully we can top it off by winning next week.
I leave you to it, a huge crowd ahead.
The entry into Burslem was tremendous, a sea of ecstatic faces and all openly showing their adulation of the first Vale side to go to and win at Wembley.
Absolutely magnificent. I never thought we'd get so many supporters. It's absolutely tremendous for us.
And of course, come next week, if you do it again, it could be double this crowd.
Wow. Can you get more than what we've had today? If this crowd really coming back, it's been tremendous.
Saturday's second Vale goal came from Bernie Slaven, the man who joined the club from Middlesbrough. At this stage, the Potteries men were well and truly in the driving seat. No one could be sure how many greeted victorious Vale, but the crowded Burslem Centre was an overwhelming sight for the club chairman.
It's unbelievable. I didn't know so many people who lived in Burslem. Actually, it's a small town. It's absolutely unbelievable.
Vale have another Wembley date on Sunday when they hope they can beat West Bromwich Albion and so win promotion along with their neighbours Stoke City.
Yes, nice to see some bedlam in Burslem there. Finally